대학생 공동주택 활성화를 위한 책임이 되어 소포진을 시작했습니다.
Distinguished guests and fellow participants, it is my great pleasure to see you all and thank you for joining this international symposium on policy and programs for sustainable housing.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for attending the international symposium which is hosted by the Center for Sustainable Housing in Korea. My name is Seungbok Lee, a director of the Center for Sustainable Housing. First of all, I'd like to say that it is a great honor for me to have an opportunity of introducing about the Center for the Sustainable Housing in Korea. The Center for the Sustainable Housing in Korea was first initiated in October 2006. It's been just 6 months now, and this center will continue to research activities until the year 2011, for 5 years. This research program is sponsored by the Korean Ministry of Construction and Transportation, and also we are pursuing some collaborative approaches by different disciplines from university academics and research institutes for both private and public, and practicing architects and engineers from the building industries. Finally, we are looking forward to having opportunities of working together for the successful progress of our research goals. So we have already have 16 agreement with the international research institutions, as you can see on this slide here. I believe this symposium today is one of those efforts, and I appreciate again all the participants of the symposium. Thank you.
Thank you, Chairman. My name is Takao Sawachi. There was about 38% increase of CO2 emission. A very large increase of CO2 emission already happened. And we need a countermeasure to reduce this. And this is about Japanese government plan to reduce CO2 emission. Especially, we are interested in the building sector. I would like to talk about the target for building sectors.
The U.S. uses a combination of pushing and pulling policies to affect our more sustainable housing. On the push side, we have appliance standards and building energy codes. Our regulatory activities. On the pull side, we have Energy Star for appliances, building components, and home energy rating systems. And we also have tax credits. These are our incentive activities.
According to the country situation, is it country that they are suitable policy measures, voluntary or recommended or mandatory. In Korea, usually depending on mandatory-based policies. Any style of policy, the government should provide the test method or product.
This house, though, would not have been possible without an integration of science and technology with programs and policies. And this, I think, is very much the theme of this session today. So we started doing this 30 years ago.
주택의 성능을 객관적인 성능 정보를 전문기관으로 하여금 평가를 받아서 공고를 하도록 이렇게 해서 입주자가 주택 소비자가 그 성능을 보고 주택을 구입할 수 있도록 하는 소비자 권리를 보호하고자 하는 게 첫 번째 목적입니다. 두 번째는 최근에 국민 소득이 향상되고 주택 보급률에 대해서도 100%가 넘어가고 있는 시점에서 현재 생활 수준이 굉장히 향상되는 상황에서 주택 품질에 대한 국민들의 기대 수준이 높아지고 있습니다.
소비자들에게 알고리즘을 시행하고 궁극적으로는 발전시키겠지만 테슬라나 인센티브라거나 개별 소비자들에게 어필할 수 있는 조금 더 권장적이고 자발적인 차원에서의 성능 등급을 업그레이드 시킬 수 있는 그런 지표가 필요할 텐데 앞으로 어떻게 생각하시는지 궁금합니다.
주택 성능 등급 표시제도는 이식의 항목에 대해서 성능을 자세하게 등급을 표시하도록 하기 때문에 소비자가 주택에 대해서 자세한 성능을 알 수가 있는 것입니다.
To persuade the people to go that way, right? In the U.S., if they did this way, then they actually contribute
the basic thinking and with the state in Arizona.
Cost becomes an issue. So, but that program has pulled.
Satisfied all the presentations and questions and answers today, symposium.